Okay, what a freaking year. That would be to say the least. So I want to take a moment to say this instead of just typing it in the post descriptions, because I feel there's just some folks that deserve mention and there are some folks I wanted to thank. First off, Ginger's family, the Dukes. There's Herman Duke, his wife Anne, her mom, Debbie Burton Duke, and Grandma Mickey, all of which this past year have put me up in their homes, have on several occasions paid for hotels and paid for passes and stuff for the for events. Thank you so much. Okay, I mean seriously, thank you. Phipps, Dynamite Dame Rose Phipps' parents at the Oklahoma. Herman, Ginger's father, paid for hotels. George paid to upgrade my hotel. And Tammy and him, George and Tammy Phipps, they also lent me the use of their live-in horse trailers rather than sleeping in my vehicle at the rodeo grounds like I do to be able to make it around these things year-round. Thank you so much for that. And Tammy also helps Ginger with the like merchandise. When Ginger does have money to purchase t-shirts and caps, stuff like that to sell, Tammy helps out on that a lot. So you don't hear about that, you don't see that. So I wanted to take time to mention that because I do feel they deserve a mention or a thank you. Dodie, thank you so much. Dodie Hall, ICU nurse, thank you so much for the encouragement while doctors were saying otherwise. Thank you for the encouragement for Ginger. For those of y'all that don't know, Dodie Hall was Ginger Duke's ICU nurse. So while the doctors were saying that Ginger was not going to ride again or take up to a year to even think about getting on a horse, Dodie was one telling her that only she knew what she was capable of. Thank you so much for that, okay? And then we're on to those that helped over at the beginning of the year. There's others that helped. There was Dusty Lee Kimsey of Tricked Out, who helped run the show for Ginger when she was over in the hospital at the Austin Rodeo, which is coming up next month. Thank you so much. And Dusty, thank you so much for letting me use your live-in horse trailer while I was staying there. See, while that was happening, the issue of where the team was going to stay at was brought up. It was not enough money for hotel rooms for 2 weeks for everybody while all the stuff was going on. Tori's grandparents, Deborah and stuff, whatever, stepped in. Her grandparents brought in a fifth-wheel RV horse trailer for the team to stay in. Thank you so much for that. That relieved a lot of pressure off Ginger. The team stayed over there. Dusty stayed with the team, and Dusty let me use her living horse trailer to stay in instead of sleeping in my vehicle once again. Brianna Cook from Australia, of Brianna Horsemanship, thank you so much for helping out. She was on an internship for 3 months here and helped fill in and with the team over here. And then there's, Kayla and Kayla Miles. She's the one that was started the page, the Smiles for Ginger Duke. She also helped a lot on the ground throughout the year especially at the Ginger's first rodeo performance in Belton, Texas last year. She did attack, wash horses, stuff, whatever. Basically, all the physical stuff going on, and still does to this day, and a lot. And around her parents' house too. So, thank you, Kayla Miles and Kevin Graham, Ginger's partner in crime. Thank you so much for helping our buddy there. And hi, Briley. That would be Kevin's son. Okay. And next, for the last two, is the whole entire team itself. At the beginning of the year, everybody gathered around me and over at Belton and gave me the freaking dog tags. These, I still have them and still love them. Official member of the Dynamite Dames, the Dynamite Dude, Roy Ortiz. Thank you so much for everybody that was there. Still have them. Will not lose them. And last but not least, thank you, Ginger. Still love my buckle. The only team buckle, rodeo-related buckle I've ever gotten in my life. Woo! Thank you so much. And on with the video.
You see, back in February, Ginger was injured very seriously. We rolled into February at about 3 weeks into there, and we didn't know if she was going to live or die. But she's a trooper. Her family came in. We prayed for her. I cried. They said, the doctor said, we don't know if Ginger's going to make it through the week. I'm not going to get into the nitty-gritty details, but it was bad. But she had faith. And the good Lord above, our Lord and our Savior, put his hand on her shoulder like I'm doing right now. And he said, it's not your time. Your time is to perform to the masses.
I am just a cowboy, lonesome on the trail. A starry night, a campfire light. The coyote call and the howling winds wail. So I'll ride out to the old sundown.
Riding in the rodeo.